guys, Wholesome Mom Life here. I am here with a new video today. I'm so excited to film reasons why maybe you shouldn't become a couponer, things that no one tells you when you get started. I know no one told me, so I'm here to help you before you decide to go on this journey. Don't get me wrong, couponing is great, but it does take a lot of time and energy, and I'm gonna get into the reasons why maybe it wouldn't be for you here in a minute. If you do enjoy my content, please like and subscribe, and also comment down below if you have any questions or suggestions for future content. So if you guys could help me out with that, I would really appreciate it. Without further ado, let's get into this video. So reason number one why you should not become a couponer is because it does take dedication to learn the skill set. And I know that sounds so silly because you're like, how hard can couponing be? But honestly, it is a skill set. It's something you will learn. It does take time. It's one of those things you can study it all you want, and then you have to actually get out there and do it to really understand how to do it. And every single store is different that you're gonna coupon at. So if you don't have the time to dedicate to this, then couponing is probably not for you. Speaking of time, reason number two why you should maybe not become a couponer is because couponing is very time consuming. I think most people that coupon would tell you that it is time consuming. It really does come down to how many stores you coupon at and how often you go couponing, but in general, I would say I definitely spend a significantly more amount of time couponing than I used to prior to couponing. So between educating yourself on how to coupon, actually planning your deals, following deals, to actually going to the store, to bringing your items home and putting them away and organizing them in your stockpile, the hours do add up. If someone tells you it's not time consuming, they're probably not telling you the full truth. So I will just let you know. Couponing is time consuming, and if time is money to you, couponing is definitely not for you. For me, the time that I spend couponing is totally worth it to me because of the amount of money that I do save. Reason number three why you maybe don't want to become a couponer is if you get distracted easily when you're shopping in the store. And by this, I mean if you are someone that does not have that tunnel vision to get in and get what you need and get out, and you get distracted by all these things, and then you end up putting all these things in your cart that weren't on your list, you're gonna end up spending probably more money than you were prior to couponing. So if you're someone that is gonna get distracted easily and being in the store more, it's just gonna make you spend more money, obviously couponing will not be for you. Reason number four why you maybe don't wanna become a couponer is if you do not have storage space for a stockpile. A stockpile is essential to every couponer. It's the whole essence of why we coupon, is to make a stockpile so that way when we need something like pasta or whatever it may be, we don't have to go to the store and pick it up at its full price. We already have it and we paid rock bottom for that weeks, months, days ago, whatever it may be. It's in our stockpile and we don't have to go pay full price for it. That is the whole point of being a couponer. So if you don't have room in your home or you can't make room, maybe couponing is not for you. So I will say though, I live in a very small house. Making room for a stockpile for me was my priority. So I made room even though I didn't really have the room. I also just wanna say you don't have to have a huge gigantic garage or a huge room. You could just have a little closet, maybe add in some extra shelves. You'll figure it out once you get going. Reason number five why you may not wanna become a couponer is if you are not organized. Being a couponer, you have so many things that you're doing. You clip coupons, you're checking different sources for information, you're reading sales ads. You have to be writing your deals down somewhere. There's no way any of us could remember this off the top of our head, all the deals that are happening at every store every single week. So you really have to be organized. You have to organize your coupon binder, or maybe you don't clip your coupons, maybe you file them by insert date. Either way, you have to be organized, and you also have to organize your list. So if you're not an organized person, maybe couponing is not for you. Reason number six why you may not want to become a couponer is if you don't want to be in the store a lot. I know right now, especially with COVID and everything going on, people are really trying to stay out of the stores. But I will tell you, as a couponer, you will spend a lot of time in stores. If you're looking at my past videos, you're probably seeing where I'm not in the store very much. I've been doing Walmart and Kroger pickup. Thankfully, Kroger allows coupons with their pickup orders, but Walmart does not, so that's just something to keep in mind. In general, you will be in the store quite a bit if you're a couponer. So if you don't want to be in the store very often, couponing may not be for you. And reason number seven why you may not want to become a couponer is if you do not have thick skin. I don't want to deter anyone away from couponing. However, I do think this is one of the reasons why people end up giving up on couponing after they start, is because they don't like that confrontation they have to have with certain cashiers or other customers, and it can be very frustrating. I know I've personally had an experience that left me in tears, and after that I almost quit couponing, but I decided to stick with it, and I'm so glad I did, and now I'm a lot more confident because of that experience. That being said, you can't be, you know, rude to your cashiers and other customers. You're gonna have instances where you're in the store and a cashier questions you and maybe says you can't get this, even though you know deep down in your soul that it is right. And sometimes you do have to walk away, and sometimes you have to put your foot down and pull out that coupon policy and say, hey, I'm so sorry, I'm not trying to like step on your toes, but this is actually your coupon policy and I've done a lot of research and I know that this deal is supposed to go through. Sometimes your coupons are beeping and they're not supposed to. There's a huge line behind you. Customers get angry, they get irritated, the cashier gets anxious. All of us couponers have been there, we've done that. As you get more experienced, you may not have as many confrontations, and I promise you stores will know you're the couponer when you come in. They'll know, oh, that's the couponer. And most of the time we all have our big coupon binders with us or whatever it may be. So stores will know that you're the couponer eventually once you get going. And they don't question you as much once they know how experienced you are. But yes, at the beginning, there's gonna be a lot of confrontation. There's gonna be instances where you're not really sure what you're doing. It's what happens, unfortunately. It doesn't happen every time, but it does happen. So that may be a reason why you don't wanna become a couponer. I hope that this video was helpful to someone out there, or many of you out there. Please let me know in the comments below if you enjoyed this video and if it was helpful to you. I really don't want to deter anyone from couponing, because seriously, it has changed my life. It has made my life so much better. I spend so much less money. But I will say, all of these reasons that I've just mentioned can keep someone from couponing. And as much as I don't want it to happen, it's just the reality of couponing. Don't forget to like this video and comment and subscribe if you enjoy my content. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye guys.